Hello students, how are you? I hope you are fine at your home. Today I am again back with a new topic, that is speed control of separately excited DC motor. Now what happening this is, as I am saying separately excited DC motor, you must know what is separately excited DC motor. This is field winding and the resistance of the field winding, and this is the resistance, variable resistance. This is exciting supply we are giving, okay, and this is our motor, DC motor with back EMF and armature resistance RA, and here you are giving the supply input. Now this is the input supply we are giving, and from here the current, again load resistance, load current and armature current is coming, and we know that from here Vin is equal to IARA drop plus EB plus brush drop, actually 2 VB, that we ignore. Now from here EB is equal to Vin minus IARA. Now how we can control the speed? We know that this is the formula for back EMF, phi n p a upon 60 a, phi n p, phi is a flux, n is a number of n is a speed, and p is a number of poles, and z is a conductor. Now from here we know that z is constant, okay, poles is constant, number of poles is constant, A is the number of parallel path, that is also constant. Now from here we conclude I is directly proportional to phi into n, and phi is a flux, n is a speed and RPM, the revolution per minute. Okay, now from these two equations, now from here you can say the speed is directly proportional to EB upon flux. Now put the value of EB. What is EB? We know that Vin minus IARA upon flux. Now from here we can say speed is depending upon three parameters. One is armature resistance, okay, RA, speed can be changed by changing the armature resistance. Second is, it is depending upon the flux, armature flux, okay, and the third is, it is depending upon the armature voltage, input voltage. Now with these three parameters, with the help of these three parameters, we can change the speed of the DC motor, and especially we are discussing separately excited DC motor. From the first method, now in case one, how we can change the speed with the help of, by changing the armature resistance. Now what we will do is, again draw the speed diagram of the motor. Now here I have drawn the extra resistance RE, here is the armature resistance EB, and this is RF, okay, here we are given the supply Vin. Now as you see from the equation, that is speed is Vin minus IARA. Now the extra resistance you have added, the current IA is coming. Now it is not IARA, it is IARA into RA IARA upon phi. Now what happens is, this IARA increase, okay, hence when RA increase, the IARA increase, therefore speed decrease. from the speed current curve before and after. Now this is the general curve. Okay, when IR drop is zero, speed and current curve. Now this was the curve when there is no external resistance we have added. Okay, now after that the curve will be like this. The speed decrease actually. More resistance we add, more the speed decrease. The curve will be like this. Okay. Hence we can vary the speed. Second parameter is by changing the flux. Now how we can change the? Now second case 2. In this very diagram, what we will do is by changing the flux. Okay. Now we are considering the second method, flux. How we can change the flux? We will just add a resistance, variable resistance RE, in parallel with the field resistance. This field resistance will produce the flux phi. Is producing the flux phi. Now what happens is, in this case, as we have increased the flux resistance, therefore that is RE is increased. If the resistance increase, the current flowing in this, that is IE increase or decrease, current decrease. As the resistance increase, current decrease. When the current decrease, the flux is directly proportional to current, we know that. Hence the flux also decrease. As the flux is decreasing, we know that speed is EB minus IARA upon flux. If flux decrease, then speed increase. Hence speed can be increased. Now in this case also you can increase the speed at higher level. Okay. Now the third case. Now in the third case, speed can be changed with the help of changing the input voltage of the armature. Now this can be discussed by using Ward-Leonard method. Now what is according to the Ward-Leonard method of voltage? Ward-Leonard method. Okay, Ward-Leonard drive system is the third method of changing the voltage V in. Okay, now we'll give the three phase supply to the induction motor. Now this motor, when run, will drive the generator. This is generator. Okay, and this generator will further drive the motor. Now the exciting coil of the generator is variable. This is the exciting coil of the generator. Okay. And this is the exciting coil of the motor. And here we give the DC supply. To excite the exciting coil to produce the flux. Now what happens is, here we are giving the three phase supply to the induction motor. When the induction motor run, what happen is, it will start the generator, as generator need a starter. Okay, it start the generator and generator start producing the voltage. Hence it starts producing the voltage, hence it produce the voltage V in for the motor. Now how this voltage, as the method is, third method is by changing the V in voltage changing can be changed. It can be changed with the, that is, exciting coil of the generator. As we change the current in the exciting coil, what happen is the generator change, as the generator voltage is EG, the back name of the generator, that is the generated, is equal to V in plus IRA. Okay, as RF is changed, radio, this is the frequency change, V in is changed or increased, then you can say EG change, EG also increased. Okay, EG change, V in change. Hence, you can say the voltage across the motor can be changed. But this method, disadvantage is, it is very much costlier one, because we need one induction motor, one generator. Okay, that is quite costlier and heavier one. This method is also occupying more space. But the advantage is, in this method we can change the voltage up to higher level, whatever is the requirement. Thank you so much. This is all about today's topic. Stay tuned. We'll soon meet tomorrow with a new topic. Thank you so much.